Hey everyone, welcome back to the latest GoSkills Excel Challenge solution. How close did you get to solving it? Well, we've got Microsoft trainer Deborah Ashby ready to share her solution. Check it out right now.
So let's take a look at how we might go about solving this challenge. Now the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to put my data set into a table. Control T. Yes, my table has headers. Let's click on OK. And I don't really like the formatting of the table, so I'm just going to choose another table style. Let's click the drop down. And I'm going to choose that one, but I'm going to turn off banded rows and also the filter button. If you chose a different table style there, that is absolutely fine. I'm also going to give my table a name. So if we go up to the Table Design tab, in the first group here, the Properties group, instead of just the generic name of Table 3, I'm going to call this Sales by Manager and hit Enter. Now the reason why I've put my data into a table is because I asked you to make everything dynamic, so that if we add new managers to the bottom, everything is going to update. And that's the cool thing about tables, is that they auto expand to accommodate any new data that you add. So that is what I was looking for there. The next step of this challenge is to create Add Data Validation drop-down list in cell H5. And what we want in here is a unique list of the regions. Now, if you take a look in the region column in the table, you can see that currently we have duplicates. So we need to get rid of these duplicates before we create Add Data Validation. Now there are a couple of different ways that you can do this. If you have Microsoft 365, then you can use the newer unique function. If you don't have Microsoft 365, you can simply Control Shift Down Arrow and copy all of the regions, Control V to paste them somewhere else, and then you can simply use the Remove Duplicates button to produce a unique list. Now I do have Microsoft 365, so I'm actually going to use the unique function, and I'm just going to put this over here because my chart's actually going to cover this up anyway. So I want a unique list of the region array. Let's close the bracket, hit enter, and there we go. So now I have my unique values. Let's create the data validation in cell H5. We're going to jump up to the data tab, into data tools, and let's choose data validation. We want to create a drop-down list, and our source is our unique list in column N. Now, if you have used the unique function, you can simply select the first one and press the pound symbol or the hash symbol, whatever you like to call it, and that will select the entire array. And now we have our unique drop-down list. The next part of this challenge was to utilize our selection in the drop-down to pick out of the table all of the managers for whatever region we have selected. And I also asked for an additional piece of criteria. Not only are we picking out of the table the region, we also only want records where the sales are greater than or equal to 1600. Now for this, we can use the filter function. So let's type in equals filter. So the first argument here is the array. Now the array is basically what we want to return. Now I want to return all columns in the table. I'm looking to return the manager, the region, and the sales. So I can pretty much select everything in my table. Notice that it's using table references as opposed to cell references. The next argument is to specify what we want to include. So this is basically where we list out our criteria. So our first piece of criteria is that we only want to return records where the region column is equal to the value in cell H5. Now I need to put my criteria inside brackets, and I'll explain more why I'm doing this in a moment. So we want to say include when the region column is equal to what we have in cell H5. And I'm going to press F4 to lock that in place. Close the bracket. We then need an asterisk, and we need to open another bracket where we can add our second piece of criteria. And our second piece of criteria is we only want to return records where the sales, so I'm going to select that column, are greater than or equal to 1600. Close the bracket. Now, the reason why I have these in brackets is because I have two pieces of criteria. If I only had one piece of criteria, so maybe I was only filtering by region, I wouldn't need the brackets. But as soon as you have more than one, you need to surround each piece of criteria with those brackets. And the asterisk in between them is basically an and condition. So I'm saying return all records where the region is east and the sales are greater than or equal to 1600. Now I need to close off my filter function. Let's hit enter and check out what we get. So now what we should find is that when we change our selection, everything updates nicely. The next part of this exercise is to use this data here to build a column chart. Now, I don't need to use all of this data in the column chart. I don't really need to show the region because we're going to have the region in the chart title. So I'm going to select the manager column. I'm going to hold down control and select sales. And then we're going to insert a 2D column chart. And I'm going to move that over here so that it covers up my unique list. Now, as I said, I don't really mind how you formatted this chart. I'm just going to use a chart style for quickness sake. Let's go for style 6. And I'm going to change the color so it matches a little bit better. Now, another thing I'm going to do is let's just add some data labels. And I'm going to move these inside the bars. So Control 1 to open up Format Data Labels. And for label position, I'm going to say inside end. And I'm also going to make these bars a little bit wider. Control 1, let's take that gap width down. And if you did a bit more formatting, that is absolutely fine. So let's make sure that our chart is working. Let's select north. Yes, those figures are changing. So everything looks good so far. The final part of this challenge was to create a dynamic chart title that updates depending on our selection in the dropdown. Now, this is actually really simple to do. If we scroll down just to a spare cell down here, we can just use concatenation in order to do this. So I want the chart title to say South Region dash Sales by Manager. So I'm going to type in equals. I want it to use whatever we have selected in cell H5. I want to join it, so I'm going to use the ampersand symbol with a space. So we want south space, and then we want to join that with the word region. Then we want another ampersand because we want a space dash space. And the final piece of text is sales by manager. Hit enter and check out what we have. South region sales by manager. If I change the dropdown to West, it updates to West Region Sales by Manager. So now we have our chart title working, we simply need to link it to the chart. So where we currently have the sales title, we can click on the box, go up to the formula bar, type equals, and then we can simply choose our title. Hit enter. So let's make sure everything is working. Let's pull that through. So south, I can see all the results in the table below, and I can see that my chart has updated and also my chart title. And let's just double check that the dynamic part of this table is also working. So I'm going to add myself onto the bottom of this table, and I am in the south region, and let's say 2000. Because what I should find is that I've been added to the bottom of this list because I meet both pieces of criteria. I'm in the south region and I have sales greater than or equal to 1600. So the table is automatically updated, as has the chart. You can see I now have my own bar on the end of this chart. And that's how I solved this challenge. Tell us what you think about our solution to this challenge by commenting below or joining the conversation on our Slack channel. That's it for now, and I will see you next time.
So there it is. Did you get the same results? Did you use the same approach? Or did you try something different? We'd like to know. Share your take on the challenge in the comments below, or join us for more discussion in our Slack channel. Link in the description. Thanks for participating, and make sure to subscribe to this channel to get an alert when the next challenge is released. We'll see you then.